Oh boy, have I got a runny nose or what? Yeah, no, that should be fine actually. I don't want to do it this way because it's got my address on it. Actually, it might be easier that way because it's... Alright, I'm gonna undo this bit first because it's got my address on it. And then once I've gotten like the actual box open, then I'll obviously unbox the whole thing. But yeah, I just don't want to put my address out there, obviously. Yeah, there's already a couple that I'm looking for. This is my second unboxing on Twitch, just to give it a go. Oh, you're from Reddit as well, aren't you? I noticed your name there. I did a second unboxing not too long ago, about 3 days when it came out on launch. I've had the box for about 3 days now, but I've just been really busy with work and stuff, so I haven't really had time to open it. But I did actually already unbox quite a lot of the Opus 2 stuff already, so... Here's a couple of the new stuff and that. I've got a legendary pile here, so... Where did I put the legends? I have no idea. I had all the legends somewhere. But yeah, I've already opened 17 packs, so... that's cool. Thanks for stopping by. I mean, if you're in the US, hopefully, it's not too much of an agonizing wait for you guys. It really sucks because, having more people to play and just discuss the game with, it'd just be really cool. It'd just be really cool to see the community kind of grow, and hopefully Square Enix pick up on that. Are you in the US, can I ask? Where did all my legends go? Oh, here we go. Here's the next set. I've already gotten quite a lot already of Opus 2. But this is my first actual booster box. Australia. Oh yeah, okay, so you're from the good old Down Under. I'm from London myself, so greetings. Welcome. Must be quite late for you there, isn't it? Already got it flowing freely. That's good. Glad to see you guys got it as well. I mean, that would kind of make sense. I think, like, it's quite funny when it comes to stuff like games and stuff. Australia seems to get the same kind of timing with... Europe, so that's always good. I know you guys are the same power region as well when it comes to stuff like games and movies and that, so it doesn't really surprise me, but I'm glad to see Square Enix supported you guys down there as well. Only 11 p.m. Oh, okay. This may last about 2 or so hours, because I last time it was 17 packs, it lasted an hour and 45 minutes just to talking to people, but hopefully I'll make it good for you in that case, in case it doesn't get too out of hand. So I'm just unwrapping the box as well at the moment. Because obviously I don't want to put my address out there on Twitch. So at least I can do this. Ta-da! So how many packs have you bought so far then? Did you buy a box or have you just bought like random packs and stuff? I'm going to keep this box. I really like this. Oh yeah, what was that thing as well? I'll show you. I found my Opus 2 stuff I've gotten already. Like, too many. Nice. I got quite a decent amount of stuff. So, Seth, I'm going to... It's got Warrior of Light, Renoa, Shiny, Cecil, the Emperor, Emperor's End, Amon, Gabranth, Doctor... I think that was it. And that was out of 17 packs as well. I got those three legends, like 6 or 7 legends. It was a really, really good set that I managed to get out of the box. But now this is my first actual box. But basically close to 3 boxes last count. That's nuts.
That is insanely crazy.
I was doing this with when Pokemon, like all the new stuff with Pokemon. But I've kind of dialed it back now, to be honest, with Pokemon. But yeah, let's actually get into this then. It might be like last time where a lot of people will start like popping in and stuff, because I had about 30 or so people watching last time, and that was just for 17 packs, so I'm gonna really go all out on this one. I'm quite excited, it's my first one. I missed out a lot of Opus 1, so I've been I think with this box here, plus the 17 packs, I'll kind of just leave it there. There's no real reason for me to kind of pick up anymore. I think I'll have at least enough for at least trading and stuff. But there's one last thing, and that's just to grab a bin bag as well. I just realised, just to set this all up. Obviously, I don't want to put all the rubbish in there somewhere. So, yeah, that's... I'm hoping... I'm sure that I'll get a lot of good stuff. When it comes to, like, pack pulls, I have generally very good pack pulls. Yeah, I've been told that as well. It'd just be nice if I had... a lot of the Opus 1 box, just the box, so I've got stuff to mess around with, like from Opus 1, like plenty just to mix and match, because I'm still missing a lot of the key stuff. Like, I've only got, like, I don't have a single Minwoo, I'd like a Maria. I did pick up still a lot of Opus 1 stuff in the end. Is this all my Opus 1 stuff? No, this is Opus 2 as well. Man, what the hell? Yeah, no, I've got Opus 1 stuff somewhere. I still think I picked up about 20... Yeah, here's all my Opus 1 stuff. I still picked up, like, about 20 or so packs overall. And attended, like, one tournament. Or just an event, even, I should say. So... I did manage to get some Opus 1 stuff, but if I just had a box, it'd just be nice to really get into it. So, yeah, enough faffing around. Let's, see what we've got. That is quite nice. So, I guess I'll just empty out the box just to... make it easy to work with, because, you know, a little bit of space here. On the Street Fighter X Tekken Arcade stick. Alright, let's put this in, and we'll put this over here, and we'll put this over as well. What's it? It's 36 packs, isn't it? Yeah, same as Pokemon, 36 packs. That's cool. I've got a little bit of storage now as well. And also, I've kept this in good condition, the actual box, so I can use that for storage. Enough faffing around, let's get to it. So we'll just do it by one set each. So that's what, 12 packs I think it is? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. Yeah, obviously, it's 36 divided by 3. Alright, let's do this. I've been buying random Opus 1 cards off eBay as well, so just to really keep up with it. So if there's any Opus 1 stuff, I'm like, oh, I might need that. I'll just go buy, them off eBay, which they haven't been too bad actually. So here we go, 1 out of 36. Bless RNG, yeah, the RNG Jesus. So let's get started. Got Ninja. If there's any cards you want to see that you haven't seen or you're interested in, just let me know, and I'll go back to that card and. I'll go back to that card and, you know, can show you a little bit more if there's any you want to see. So yeah, Ninja. Scholar. How should I lay it? I need to lay it out as well. So Ninja, I'll do it like this. Ninja. Scholar. Imitation Liegeman. Ranger. Monk. Fleeting Flash. Summoner. Oh, Emperor Zand again. Oh, okay. That's a good start. I've now got, what, two of these, I think? Two of the foil Emperor Zands. Not too bad. Not too bad. Oh, wait, I just realised as well. I should probably send a WhatsApp to my friend. Hold on a sec. Well, that was a good start. There was one pack I had last time which had an amazing pull rate. Yeah, had an amazing pull rate, and it gave me, like, two legendaries and, like, a really decent, like, rare as well, and hero. I was like, what the hell happened to this pack? It was ridiculous. Yeah, so that's pretty cool. That's my second Emperor Zand, and I'm quite fortunate in that it was a shiny-looking thing as well. It's an interesting card. You can only play with Fire CP. You can only play with Fire Crystal Points to play Emperor Zand onto the field. When Emperor Zand attacks, choose one forward, opponent controls... deal 5,000 damage to it. When Emperor Zan is put into the villain into the break zone, choose one for the opponent controls, deal 9,000 damage. This card, man, for 5, it's quite expensive, but for 9,000, 5 drop, and what it does, man, that's interesting. That's really interesting. Then we've got Rydia. I'll keep an EX pile as well. So I just do like the normal kind of rares and so on, and then go up to the EX set. We've got Shawla. Yeah, that's the rare, isn't it? Then we've got Fusoya at the back. Cuchulainn, the impure. Okay, I've seen that one. I've got that one already. It's the rare. It's quite cool. I'll put these down here, actually. Like EX.
The EX stuff.
Just going to look through that. And I got a good hero card. I've actually got this my second one now as well. I'm actually quite interested in this. It's just 2s, 1, 4, deal 7,000 damage. But it also deals you 1 point of damage. So I guess there's a little bit of synergy with that and like War of Antiquity. Because you can... Because basically you can just do that. Take the 1 point of damage. And you then gain the plus one point. Which means that... If I can find it... Because it's that one card, War of Antiquity, which gains 1,000 damage for every... for every point that you take. So I mean there's a little bit of synergy there. I'm not really a huge fan of just taking a huge 1 point of damage. It's up to the opponent to do that, not for me to, you know, give it for free. But it can make a difference between you and War of Antiquity and the other one, whatever it was called. It was a mannequin. Oh, and this one as well. This one works the same. It's one more, but it's basically for each point of damage you receive, Darknight gains 1,000. So yeah, there's that. War of Antiquity breaks at 6,000 when you gain 6 points of damage. So there's this one here, which just constantly buffs itself up to 11,000 at most. So that's quite interesting. No real
use for that one, but it could be, you know, the point between defending with a break and stuff.
Earth Cecil from OPUS-1. That's cool. I'll have to look into that. I do have an Earth Cecil OPUS-1 as well. So we've got a good start here. We've got Larsa. Phantasmal Harlequin. Kyros. 7k plus 5k plus EX Burst Tricks. Yeah, there's things I reckon you can do with that. I'm not too knowledgeable in the game, so any suggestions is pretty cool for me to try out. We've got Rosa. Montblanc. Edward. Ninja. I should probably move a little bit closer. Ninja. Lemon Sorbet. Balthier, which is the rare. Vanille. For Sawyer again. And I think that's Rubicante in the back. Yeah, Rubicante as the hero. That's cool. For Sawyer, normal. And then Rubicante in the back, which again is another interesting fire card. So, next pack, let's go. And so it begins, pack number 3. Bard. Yeah, I was doing it the wrong way around. I've got Bard, White Mage, Ephemeral Phantom, Capricious Thief. Oh, I've got Renoa in the back, yeah. Another Renoa. Spoilers. That's the thing about these packs. It's not like Pokemon where you get to like that one. It just... Because you can do this, and because of the texture on here, it just slides off so I can see it already. So yeah, I got another shiny Renoa. Capricious Thief. There we go. War of Antiquity. This one gains 1,000 points for each damage that you've received. It's only a 3-drop, but it breaks when it gets to 6 points of damage. So, you know, there's also that. There we go. What the hell? Okay, so here's the difference between these two then that I'm interested in. We'll put this down here. So you can see these both work pretty much exactly the same. This is a higher one, and it can go up to 11,000. This one can also be a high one, but breaks at 11,000 because once you hit 6 points of damage, this one goes into the break zone. This one here is just for a 4-drop, but it starts at 5 at the same and gains 1,000 and doesn't break at any point. So that's just really weird how I talk about these things and it just happens. Like last time when I was streaming, there was doing the 17 booster unboxing. There was a card I was talking about. It was the Ashura card, which I really like. I don't know if you've seen it. It's one that I really want to give it a try.
I really, really like that card. Let me try and find it. Where is that card? I've only got one, which is annoying, but I'm sure I'll get one here. But yeah, I don't know if you've seen the Ashura card. It's really impressive. Where is it? It was the hero, wasn't it? These are all commons. Where's that bloody hero card? Yeah, so you've seen... Oh, there we go. So I was just... the very last pack that I had, I was going, oh yeah, there's this one win card that I saw that on a YouTube video. Someone was unboxing it. Funny enough, I saw them from Reddit as well. They were doing unboxing. And then, yeah, the very, very final pack of the whole 17, I was talking about it, and then out it comes, Ashura. I was like, wow, that is exactly what I wanted. It's such a really cool card. For a one drop as well, like, oh my days. But yeah, out of nowhere, I start talking about those two cards, and the next thing you know, the packs give me the thing. Like I said, I've got really interesting pull rates when it comes to card games, which is just Pokemon and Final Fantasy at the moment. But yeah, it's really funny. I'll be talking about it, and it'll come out. Or I'll get like an amazing card that everyone wants or something like that. So yeah, back to this, Sid. The Shiny Rinoa, that's my second Shiny as well. Is that a dent? Oh no, it's just a bit of lighting. So yeah, my second Shiny Rinoa, that's cool. I've got two of these to play with. We've got Zargabath as the rare. We've got Fran as the next rare. Parom. And the hero is Shelk, which is pretty cool. I'm quite interested in that. I like the way that that kind of card works. Especially when you've got the Shawla out in play. Oh, I've got a message. Oh, it's just a message from game. There's like an event tomorrow there.
Field fodder.
Yeah. So, it's really annoying because like if I do this, it's going to slide off straight to the shiny. Yeah, there we go, it's Edge. It's just, I really wish that it was a little bit more, less spoilery, but oh, well, I'm not that fast, I'm going to get it anyway. So, Horn. Black Mage. I should probably do like this. Black Mage. No-No. Gurdy. Ephemeral Vision. Black Mage, Viking, got a random text, trying to combo gimmick decks based off Waste, Shulk, Godot from OPUS-1, Fire 4, 2 or less, yeah, there's also that other card as well, you know, Nero, because that works with Waste, Weiss even, because you've got Shawla, which works with Shulk. And you've got Nero that works with Rice. So there's also that as well. There's like these cards that, like, you know, if this card's in hand, if this card's out on the field even. So this one here, it says, like, if this card, if you control Shawla. No, Shawla's one is if you control Shulk. Same as Nero, if you control Rice, then you gain like 1,000 damage. So there's a couple there. I've got Edge as the hero. Selfie. We've got Hashmall Bringer Order. This isn't an EX Burst, but I'll put it... Oh no, it's not... Yeah, it's just that normal. And we've got the Seraphie. Seafa, even. And then Edia. That was a really interesting pack between Heroes and Rares there. That's quite nice. Yeah, Warrior, Knight, Cyclops, I should really be putting them down here, Carbuncle, actually I might sort the summons out as well, just for, so I know what I'm looking at, Summoner, Lemon Sorbet, Sid Polandino, Orme is the shiny rare thing. Pain EX is the rare, that's quite cool. Belias the Gigas, that's quite cool. I do like that card as well, it's pretty decent. It gives you one 1,000 power haste and first strike, and you get to draw a card. Like, alright, cool. Oh, that's cool. Giss. Oh, I've got Edia. That's cool. Is it the shiny? No, it's just the regular one. Damn. Really, that's not shiny. But yeah, we've got Giss, the rare. And the Edia Full Art, or whatever you want to call it, the legendary. I'm used to Pokemon again, saying Full Art and stuff. But yeah, it's a really nice card. I really like the shiny version of that. Definitely, in terms of the way it looks, it's definitely one of the best. But that's an expensive ability, though. Choose one forward, break it. It's just called Death. It's like there's that other one as well, called Bash, which I've just managed to just state, and I've got it here. It's quite expensive. It's the same. 3 fire energy plus any 2. This is basically the same, but with one less. So it's the same plus 4 lightning energy. But yeah, that one's like a nuke that just 9,000 damages 2 cards. That's interesting. I do quite like that. I love the artwork, though. So we've got that card I can't pronounce, we're calling Banman. Redus, I'm not really a fan of that card. Moomba EX. Imaginary Champion. Ranger. Ninja. Summoner. Batman again. Mateus the Corrupt. Ormi. Oh, wait, I've done them in the wrong thing, haven't I? The wrong pile. Yeah, then Ormi. Drake's Drace? That is a new one. It's from 13. If you control Larsar, the cost to play Drace into field is reduced by 2. It cannot become 0. If you control a card named Larsar, Drace gains 2,000 power plus first strike. That's quite cool. And then, see what I'm saying? I just said... Oh, and there's that one card called Bash. I quickly flicked through my entire set, moved it open. I basically just did this. I was like, oh, I wonder where Bash is. And then, oh, look, there he is. And I was just saying Bash, and here we go. It comes out of the pack. It's really weird. I'm telling you, dude, it's really weird. I can just say things and it will happen. I was just talking about Bash. Here we go. Oh, what the pack was like, oh, let's just quickly materialize a Bash on the back. So yeah, here we go, Bash. It's the hero. It's like I said, it's the nuke for 9,000. This whole thing really catches me out as to why I can just say a card and it'll appear. I don't know. It's really, really strange. Oh, that's a little bit of packaging there. Yeah, it's really weird. I'll just say a card and it will just appear. It will just appear. I don't get it. I'll be talking about it and I'll be like, oh yeah, there's this one card. Next thing you know, this pack's going to have it. I don't know, maybe this will have a Vincent in it or something. That'd be nice. So yeah, we've got White Mage, Moomba, Ephemeral Phantom, Edward, Capricious Thief, Sid Bolandina, Dark Knight. Oh, Ninja, that's cool. Oh, for fuck's sake. Oh my god. See what I'm saying? I just said it. I just said it. I did not know. You saw me open that pack. I did not know. So there's a Vincent as the hero. Rosso is the rare. Agrius. And then Edge as the hero. Man, I told you. It's so weird. It's so weird. It's really weird. I don't get it. It's such a weird thing. I don't know. It's not the legendary Vincent, but still, like, oh man. I don't know. It's weird. It's really weird. I was hoping for that legendary Vincent, but no. It's such a weird thing. Like, I don't know. As far as I know, yeah, you have to keep playing energy to get the Vincent, don't you? Yeah. Whenever it attacks or blocks, you have to play 2 energy, any 2 energy. If not, then he breaks. But when he blocks or attacks, choose one forward, deal 4,000 damage. That's a bit of a weird card, that is. I can't think of any other card that's like that, but... Yeah, you'll see what I'm saying. I'll say a card and it'll appear. It may not be the best Vincent, you know, the fabled legendary one, but man, I can never get used to this whole thing about just saying a card and next thing you know, you get it. Oh, God. It's weird. Really weird. I don't know. It just really creeps me out every time I say a card and then it just appears. I just don't even know anymore. So Larsa, Cyclops, Yang, Carbuncle, Fleeting Flash. I'll just move it a little bit closer to you for the camera. Dragoon, Herdy, Porom. Yeah, that's a hero. We've got Laguna, Penelo, Kane, and the last one is Kenny Senna. What game is that from? Oh, Final Fantasy 14, that's probably why. I've not really played 14. I played it for like maybe like a month and I just dropped it. But the artwork for 14, that like overall I'd say the artwork for Final Fantasy 14 is easily the best. Like their cards look the best easily. But yeah, it's pretty cool. When Kenny Senna enters the field, choose one forward of cost 5 or more the opponent controls, so it's just a break basically. Quite expensive though, but I mean if you get that when you put it into the break zone, that'd be quite interesting. I've not had that card yet. So we've got Bard, Redus, Imitation Liegeman, Rosa, Summoner, Capricious Reaper. Is an Alexander backup, is it? Oh yeah. I've got an Alexander here. I've got an Alexander as well, sitting somewhere. That's pretty interesting. I just realised, yeah, I didn't take that in. Yeah, Capricious Reaper, Viking, Vayne. Oh, I've got a Legendary. Haven't seen that one yet. We'll put that one to the side for now. Teller, I really like this card. It's just like, oh, tilt and then tap and then just blow up a card for 9,000. So that's the rare. Oh, there we go. Nero, the one I was just talking about. I managed to get it. Then we've got Quistis and Kane as the hero. So yeah, this is a new one I haven't gotten yet. A new shiny legendary, which is Vayne. The forwards of cost 5 or more. The forwards of cost 5 or more opponent controls. What? The forwards of cost 5 or more opponent controls won't activate at the controller's active phase. When Vayne, I don't quite understand that. If it's a 5 or more, it doesn't activate on the controller's active phase. Not too sure what that means. When Vayne enters the field, dial all forwards of cost 5 or more the opponent controls, and then I'll just dial it. Freeze all the forwards opponent controls for the same and two extra. So yeah, that's quite cool. Yeah, it's just really weird wording though. It says basically five, it won't untap. Yeah, it's quite interesting, that is. That can be really annoying. Oh, okay. Yeah. It's just there's a lot of like conditions. I think there's a Renoa in the back of this. So I guess we'll get that out of the way. Here's Renoa. Because I saw it there. I've now got 3 Renoas, only 2 of them are shiny though. So I've got Astrologian, Ninja, Machinist. It locks down big units. Yeah, I mean I'll have to look into that. I don't really play it that much, but I mean I don't really know too much about it, but I'll have to look into that kind of tech. Chocobo, Ranger, Ninja, Dragoon, Irvin, which I do quite like. When it comes into the field, just deal 6,000 damage, why not? That is the hero. Did I put that right? Yeah, common. Yang, Saz, that's my third one, and Adramelech, the Wrath, which I think is my second now. What was that one you were talking about? Vayne, yeah. Yeah, I'll have to look into that. Well, again, I'm pretty new at the whole thing, so I don't know where you would play that and stuff. So we've got Time Mage, Van, Zell, or Arborus Simaculum, Simulacrum, Arborus Simulacrum, alright, cool. Semblance of a Witch, Felicious Wanderer, Lemon sorbet. Porom. Edge. Logos. Oh, that's cool. And Len. Oh, and I've got another one as well, which is another Ralbon. I've got three Ralbons now as well. That's pretty cool. But yeah, I've got the Len. It's pretty nice. Did I put the legendary in there as well? I think I did, didn't I? Oh, I need to keep these together. Oh yeah, I didn't get any other legendaries. It was just that. I've only gotten one legendary so far. So think of Ember Sand being dulled and never untapping. Oh, okay. Oh, that's pretty interesting. The cool thing is as well is that there's a couple of the water stuff as well, which is which is basically you can only free something once it's dull. So if you've got this and you do that and then you dull and then you free something, this gives you the ability to then instantly dull something. Since it's dulled, this will instantly give the ability for you to then play like a freeze as well, because it has to be dulled in order to freeze it. Well, unless it's like a certain condition on the card. That's pretty cool though, because that can be really handy to set you all up to start freezing the opponent as well. That's definitely a really interesting ability there. Card even. I'll have to look into that based on what you said. So, next pack. We've got Leviathan. EX Burst. Oh, that's an EX Burst as well, I didn't even realise. I'm sure these piles are a mess. Sifa. Yang. Ward. Imaginary Champion. Yeah, that's what I mean, you won't even need to. So that's why I think it's quite handy, like just based on the freezing as well, with the ice decks. Sage. Semblance of a Lion. Adramelech the Wrath. Renoa. Bergen, Grammys, and Refia from Final Fantasy III. That's cool. I was playing that game last year. They just remain dulled unless they have an activate viability to summon. Yeah, something to kill off Vayne. So now we're on to the next set. That was the first 12. Here's the next 12. About one third of the way through the box at the moment. So we've got Redus. Oh, foot cramp. Moonbit EX. Ifrit EX. Ephemeral Vision. Mont Blanc. Chocobo. Oh, hold on a sec. Got a runny nose. Chocobo. Is that Vincent? Nope. Herdy. Yang. Penelo. Teller. Agrius and Yuna as a legendary. That's cool. So I've got the two little setups there, I think, like, because it's the full artwork, isn't it, between both of them, wherever I just put that card. So like the back and forth artwork there, it's pretty cool. Let's just quickly sort out this pile on the floor of rubbish. Oh, so then, Leviathan. Oh, pile's getting a bit messed up there. Leviathan. Yeah, three. Oh, yeah, wait. Where did I put that other one? There was an Emperor Zand there as well, wasn't there? I know I've messed up the piles, because, like, there was supposed to be legendaries in here, wasn't it? Where did I put the rest of those? I swear I had, like, another legendary in here. There was Emperor Zand. And there was Edio. Oh, no, Edio was the... Yeah, that idea. Where did I put those cards? Okay, let's have a quick just recap as to where I put them, because I think I've messed this up somewhere. These are all rares. Rare. Where did I put them? You put it to the side.
Did I?
Oh. Oh, yeah, I've been putting these all to the side. Whoops. So, yeah, there's the two Renoas I got. And I put those Emperor Zans somewhere. Oh. In my other pile. Oh, yeah, there's Edia. Why is it rare there? Oh, because it's on the X-Burst. Oh, bloody hell, I've just dropped the cards. They're only commons anyway, I don't really care that much. Yeah, and the Emperor's Hand I just put somewhere as well. I don't know, I'll leave it for now. I'll find it somewhere. It's in my room somewhere. But yeah, so far I've got that, plus another Emperor's Hand. It's not been too bad for, what, 14 packs? Yeah, so I'll carry on, and I'll pick... There's only two cards that fell. It's not too bad. Yeah, it's there somewhere. Oh well. So, anyway, continuing on. Ninja. Phantasmal Harlequin. Black Mage. War of Antiquity. Viking. Ninja. Semblance of a Witch. Nero. Yang. What's his name? Grammys. And Sarcomigio Leone, whatever the hell it's called. Scarmiglione. Scarmiglione, there we go. Remember that now. Back attack. This is the new thing that's a part of the game now, isn't it? Like summon and abilities, this card can be played during either player's attack phase or main phase. So, was it Scarmiglione? That's a stupid word. Stupid name. I have to check that bag in case I've actually thrown the Emperor's Hand inside there. I'm pretty sure I wouldn't have. I don't know where I put the other pile. Yeah, where did I put the other pile? I'll find it anyway. It's in here somewhere. So I've got Van. Time Mage. Zell. Horn. Aboros de Smeculum. Semblance of a Witch. Dragoon. Oh, shiny foil, Garbez. It's the hero. Saz, Edge, Logos, and Golbez again. Oh, that's cool, two Golbezes in one pack. Not bad. And one of them being the foil as well. So next up we've got Black Mage, Batman, Yes, Capricious Reaper, Ranger, Ward, Fallacious Wanderer, oh, Hollow Nero. I keep saying Hollow because of Pokemon, Shiny Nero, whatever you guys want to call it. Renoa, Bergen, Rosa, oh, and Aishi, there we go, cool, the first one, that's my first Aishi that I got there. Or Ashi, I don't know how you want to pronounce it, but yeah, it's my first Aishi that I got, which I know a lot of people are, you know, jerking their dicks over, which is pretty cool. When Aishi is chosen by a summon or an ability of your opponent, Aishi gains plus 3000 power until the end of the turn. It's plus 2 to activate Aishi, and then Heaven's Wrath for plus 2 is Aishi gains 2000 power and first strike to the end of the turn. That's that, that's pretty cool. Final Fantasy 12 there. That's not bad. That's my first one I've gotten there. Man, because they're new cards as well, they're a little bit too stiff. Yeah, I'm going insane. Yeah, no, I didn't put them down there. Oh well. Next pack. Just for reference, I've still got plenty left. I'm only halfway through at the moment, so there's all of this still to go. So I think we're, yeah, about halfway through, so that's what, 18 packs in? So, scholar. Oh, warrior. Astrologian. Edward. Capricious Reaper. Carbuncle. Lemon Sorbet. Another Rauben. It's my third shiny of that one, actually, now. It's pretty cool. That is a hero, isn't it? Yeah. Rydia. Yeah, yeah, it is. Balthier. Drace. Oh, and I got a legendary. Whoop. It's my third Emperor now, I think it is. Yeah. No, second Emperor that I've gotten. So that was the next legendary there. The character's opponent controls cannot use special or action abilities. What the fuck, really? Did I miss that card the whole time? Damn, that's my third legendary, and I didn't even realise how good that card was. Yeah, my second Emperor from the original set. Damn. That's actually a pretty cool legendary. I'll have to look into playing something like that. I really want to play a deck that really pisses people off, where it just, like, closes them down and stuff. There's Emperor's Hands. So, yeah, there's that legendary put that together. For some reason, I've put them into the common pile. I don't know why. But, yeah, box openings are quite fun. I don't do it that much. Whenever Pokemon comes out, I get, like, a whole Pokemon box. And then you're left with all this crap to get rid of now, so I'm getting through all of that. But, yeah, I've been doing that. I do that with every Pokemon box that comes out. So Sun and Moon I'm going to be going ham on. But, yeah, Final Fantasy is a new game, so I'd like to at least get one box. I might try and buy, like, an OPUS-1 box. I might just have to, like, bite my lip and be like, screw it. And just spend, like, 130 quid buying an OPUS-1 box. Because I just like to have OPUS-1 stuff, like, plenty to work with. You never know, I might get a Light Cloud or something like that. I might just buy Light Clouds off eBay anyway, screw it. So we've got Kyros, Ninja, Ifrit, Fleeting Flash, Rosa, Sage, Semblance of a Lion, Capricious Reaper, Shawla, Zargabath, Fat Guy, and Lunaf, the hero of Final Fantasy III, which is a really good game. I really enjoyed that. Let's put these all together. I'm going to move all these cards out of the way, because I might start moving the common pile across now, because it's getting pretty big there. Let's move these across, actually, screw it. So, we've got Knight, Sifa, Machinist, White Mage, Dangerous Lethal, yeah. That is a way of wording it. So we've got Fire Summoner, Capricious Reaper, Summoner, put it out of its misery, yeah. Just like putting it all into the shredder. White Mage, Vanille, Fran, Fissoya, and the hero is a new one I don't have. Barbarissa. Yeah, we'll go with that name. Yeah, Barbarissa. So for the same, two wins and a tap, deal each forward opponent controls damage equals to his power minus 1,000. So it's basically the backup of Moomba EX, but you get to play it as many times as you want. Because Moomba EX is exactly that. So you've got Moomba EX, which is choose one forward, deal it damage equal to its power. Basically, put it onto 1,000. This one is the same as well. Deal each forward opponent controls damage equal to its power minus 1,000. So this is do it to all of them. That's really cool, actually. That's not too bad. Deal each forward opponent controls damage equal to its power minus 1,000. So it's basically just put each of them onto 1,000 points, with the exception of some like Warrior of Light, because it's 2,000 less damage. Man, that's really cool, actually. Damn, I think it's pretty interesting. It's like a little miniature nuke. It's like the wind version of the nuke, because you've got Rydia even, which is like a massive nuke that just goes off after like a countdown. Yeah, that's cool. Not bad. I'll have to look into that card. Uh, Screw it, I might as well just put the whole pile there. It basically destroys 99% of the field besides Roar of Light. Yeah, yeah, the OPUS-2 Roar of Light. I've got quite a few of those, fortunately, as well. Because I was playing that card wrong when I went to our friend's house. I realised that it does... Because it says deal damage. My friend read it out to me because he knows a lot more about the game than I do. And he's like, no, deal damage. Roar of Light takes 2,000 less damage. It's not changed the state of the card to, like, 1,000. It's deal damage. And because Roar of Light takes 2,000... I think it's like half, no, 2,000 less damage. And it's like, oh, we're playing it wrong the whole time. But I think everyone was for the first week anyway here in the, when it all came out. The pre stuff. So we've got Ninja, Scholar, Imitation Liegeman, Edward, Capricious Reaper, Felicious Wanderer, Viking. Oh, damn, I've got Zemus. That's cool. That's my third one now. Oh, wait, that's a hero. Jewel and a Bat, which I really like as well. Backups don't do any damage to the forge you control. That's a way to stop Teller. Yang. Fasoya. And the hero is Irvin again. My arse is getting well sore in this store. I need to get like a cushion or something like that. Jesus Christ. Even before Larsa. Oh yeah, it's actually a Larsa. I've realised that Larsa seems to be a starting card in a lot of these packs. And the next thing you know, I say Larsa and you get a Larsa out of it. But yeah, Larsa seems to be such, it seems like a really common opener card. So Phantasmal Harlequin, Kyros, War of Antiquity, Gurdy, Ephemeral Vision, Semblance of a Lion, Bergen, but as a holo this time. I'm going to say, what the fuck? During the same pack, I love when that happens in Pokemon. Penelo. Oh, I should probably move it a bit closer for you guys. Penelo. Len. And the hero is Ignis from Final Fantasy III. It's getting a bit too much over here, so I'm going to move all this across now. Because it's that's a massive common pile. Alright, so that's the new commons. And this stuff here goes over there. So I didn't get any legendaries as of yet, yeah. So I shouldn't be getting that many more. Emperor Zen, looks like Urine from Street Fighter as well. Crash, crash, ah. So, Bard, White Mage, Ephemeral Phantom, Black Mage, Carbuncle, Summoner, Ninja. Oh, we got it. Whoop, whoop, whoop. Legendary Holo Tifa. Foil Tifa. How many non-foil holos have I gotten so far? Oh, there goes the whole pack, the whole set. Hold on a sec. Ooh, let's pick these cards up. So... Oh man, my ass is well flat from this store. I'm gonna get a cushion or something. Jesus Christ. Just pick these up as well. Just get them out of the way. That was a Pokemon card down there. Ugh. So let me get a cushion. Because my ass is well sore. And we'll have a quick recap of the cards I've just gotten. So I know that Tifa counts as a... Tifa's a legendary, isn't it? Yeah. Oh, there we go. Much better. Jeez, I need to get that out for the last time. So, we'll quickly finish off this pack and we'll go for the non-foil legendaries. So we've got the Hype one. The hypest card so far. Logos. Was that? Oh yeah, I just moved all the commons, didn't I? Laguna. Adramelech. Oh, what the fuck? Alright, cool. Thanks game. Thanks card game, that was good. Oh, wow. See, I get some really weird packs sometimes. That was good. Thanks. That was a good pack. 2-in-1 pack, I love it. Alright, so what I got here, double legendary Tifa in the same pack. Oh, Jesus Christ. We'll sort these out. So, we've got 1, 2, 3, 4. I don't want to look over the camera. All right. And then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So five in how many have I done so far? Let me just check. 1, 2. So 1, 2, that's 12. Is it? Yeah, it's 12. So that's 15 packs. Yeah, so I've got two more. If the way that the packs are done is right, then yeah, it should be about two or so more. But fuck my ass. Two legendary Tifas in one pack. Man. Two legendary Tifas in one pack. I love it. Oh, God. That is disgusting. The foil and then the normal, the baby one afterwards. Oh, Shaymin EX. Shaymin EX. The full art Shaymin and the baby Shaymin. Oh, man. That is cool. Oh. Yeah, the packs that I got yesterday were really good as well. Like, I'll put it up maybe on Reddit, like, the next bit. When I did the unboxing yesterday, I carried on the video. And in that one box, I got, like, an amazing hero, two legendaries, and something else. I forgot what they were, but it was a ridiculous... Oh, it had one of them was the foil Renoa. But yeah, two legendary Tifas in one pack. That was a really good pack, because I had to cut... I don't know what else I picked up in there. It was Ignis, which was cool, Laguna, the Aldrimelch wealth thing. But yeah, two legendary Tifas in one pack. Mm-mm. That was tasty. The waifu, as people refer to as.
Double waifus.
So that one pack took me down by one foil and one normal legendary. So anyway, we'll carry on from that. Horn, Black Mage, yes, Imaginary Champion, Ranga, Sid Polandina. Oh, I've got some, I think, was that? Oh yeah, Dark Knight, and then Barbarossa, the Hoyle. Oh, bloody Pokemon, Hollow, Foil, whatever you want to call it. Oh, the Riku, I really want this card. Damn, I'm really happy about that. So yeah, we've got the Hollow Foil Thingamajig, Barbarossa. But this Riku, though, foils is randomly allocated. Is it random? Oh, I thought it was always set. Okay, so I'm doing 5 for 5 at the moment, I think. No, what was it? Yeah, 4. So 4. That's not too bad. And I've still got another 17 packs left. No, 19. No, 12. Yeah, what about? I'm doing the maths wrong. Another 13 packs left. But yeah, this Riku, though, damn. When Riku enters the field, activate all forwards you control. So if you get a lot of L's in foil, you're doing pretty great. Yeah, yeah. That pack, though, man. Two legendary Tifas in one pack. That was really good. Non-foils are 7 guaranteed. Oh, okay. Oh, okay, cool. So that's not too bad for 5-4 foils at the moment. And again, one of them was Tifa in the same pack. Yeah, this Riku EX is really cool. When Riku enters the field, activate all forwards you control. Man. Like, for 2 drop, like, such a good card. Oh, there's the Vincent, but not the right one. That's the rare. Quistis. Oh, and Ashura. Again, that's cool. I now only need one more, and I've got the playset. So that's the Ashura card. I really like that card. I might have to build a wind deck or something, because I really like the way wind is playing at the moment. Like, what you can do with it. And I do want to use the Riku. I've got Aerith as well. I managed to buy Aerith quite cheap off eBay. I've got quite a few more coming, but basically, eBay is actually surprisingly really cheap for a lot of the good cards. I bought an Aerith off eBay for £2. No, for £1.60. It's basically, imagine, like, I don't know, like one US, one Australian dollar, basically, for, like, an Aerith. eBay is really good for some really cheap cards. And a lot of them do deals on there as well, like buy 2, get one of them free, or buy 1, get one the next one at 25% off. I don't know if it's the same for you guys, but I'm sure, like, you know, eBay sellers, they're also doing the same thing. But yeah, it's a really, really good place to get these cards. especially a lot of the good ones. I've already got a Legendary Tifa coming at the moment. I got it for £3. I don't know if they knew what they had, but they were selling pre-release Tifa for £3, so I did it as a buy it now. Yeah, and I've managed to get a couple of the staples for eBay over the last week or so. So it's been, eBay's really, really good. Obviously, the only one that's quite insane at the moment are a couple of the legendaries, some of the really good stuff, like Zidane, and then promos for some reason are still expensive, even though I think they're quite common. And obviously, Light Cloud is like the most expensive at about £30 or so, which I think is about four. I've seen it selling. Well, I know in the US it's a bit of a mess, so they're selling for like $100 US. Because they just don't have any of the cards, which is a real shame. And I know that Opus 2 got delayed as well. I saw the post on Reddit and stuff about it, which really sucks. But yeah, it got delayed there. So even still, Opus 1 Cloud is like, you can sell them for so much more in the US. I'm sure like in Australia, it's not too bad for you at the moment. Like, I'm sure you can easily get them quite cheap as well. So anyway, back on. Warrior, Knight, Cyclops, Batman, Monk, Gurdy, Dragoon, Sifa, Rosso, oh wait, that's the rare, Laguna, Reeve is the hero, no, he's a rare, and oh, we've got the Hero Squall, that's cool, I really like this card. Basically, this card is like, first strike, dull all of the characters that your opponent controls, and you gain 1,000 for each that you do. You also dull all your opponent's backups because, like, what the hell? Like, this card, I've got this, I think it's my second one now, so yeah, it's pretty cool. I do quite like that card there. Really, really decent hero card. I'm sorry about that, just blowing my nose there. So, these are the new commons. I want to keep them to a separate and we'll recap on that. Oh, we've got something in the back here. It's all yellow. So a little sneak peek. A little sneak peek. It's a full art yellow card or something. I'm going to take a guess and say that that's Ralburn at the back there. It's a yellow, shiny, and it's most likely Ralburn. So we've got Machinist, Wit Maggie, Moomba, Fleet and Flash. Isn't that Dragon Ball Z move? Oh no, that's Final Flash. Rosa, Dark Knight, Ninja, oh, Meryl Webb, EX, Burst, I'll put that there, Selfie, Edge, Reeve, and the Holo Foil. Oh, it's a Vincent, oh, that's cool, oh, so that's what that card is, it's Vincent from the angle. Oh, so if you see that, basically, let me get an example here, if you open up your pack, and you see this, at the back, White Mage, or as I said, Whitey Maggie. Yeah, Whit McGee. We'll go with Whit McGee instead. I know it's White Mage, I'll just say like random cards. Like, I know, what's that other one called? Where is it? Oh, it was just there. Like, I don't know how you pronounce that other one. I can pronounce pretty much the cards anyway, but is this one here? Bagmanan, like put your nan in like a bag or something. I don't know. So I just call it Batman, fuck it. And we've got Whit McGee. But yeah, there we go. So if you open up a pack and you see this massive yellow thing sticking out here, that's a Vincent. So yeah, finally got a Vincent. And it's really cool. The next non-foil legendary there. Vincent cannot be broken by opponent's summons or abilities that don't deal damage. Choose as many forwards as you want. With a cost of 7 or less, break them. So yeah, death penalty. That's my second Vincent now, actually. It's pretty cool. So yeah, keep an eye out for that. If you open up a pack and you see this just sticking out, you've got a Vincent. Good stuff. Bagmanan. God, I sound like a fucking idiot right now. Bagmanan.
Bagman. It's not my first box. No, it's my it's my first box, but I've already bought a couple of Opus 2 packs. Bagman. Yeah, you know what? Fuck it, Batman. We're just gonna call it Batman from now on, 'cause I don't know how it works. But yeah, I'm pretty happy about that though. Finally got the Vincent. Not bad. And sorry. Also, welcome, brother Brett Kirk. This is my first box. But I've already about 3-4 days ago, I did open about 17 or so launch day Opus 2 packs. And I'm going to be recapping the whole thing later on anyway. Batman's good. Yeah. Same as, you know, Whit McGee and all that stuff. Why not? So we got Ephemeral Phantom. Hey, there we go, Lasso. It wasn't an opening card this time, but, you know. We've got Cyclops from the X-Men. Summoner. Capricious Reaper. Chocobo. Sid Polandina. Vedas. Orme. The Fat Guy. Palom. That thing that I'm never going to bother to pronounce. And X-Death. Yeah, I got really lucky with my last loose packs when I was last streaming on Twitch for the 17 packs. Got 5 legends from pre-release. Oh, that's cool. I think I only got 3 legends from pre-release packs. These were the legends that I got pre-release. There's another one. I think I've mixed them up somewhere as well. I got like a few Emperor Zans and that. But when I went to a few pre-release events, I got Renoa, Cecil, the Emperor, Amon, Gabrinth. I got a couple more, but they're kind of floating around somewhere. I don't know where they've gone, but probably in that pile over here. But yeah, I got a couple of legendaries. Nothing too special. This box has been amazing. You might have just missed it, but I just pulled 2 legendary Tifas from one pack. It was insane. It's definitely a highlight of the box. And in the last pack, just as you joined, I managed to get the legendary Vincent as well, which I'm quite happy about. So what's this one? This is a new one. 5 legends from 7 loose packs, 9 in your box. Damn, that means you picked like the best packs in that five really those pre-release packs you got were really good then. Nice pickings there. And this is my first X-Death. When X-Deaths enter the field, you may play 1 job mannequin. Cost 4 or less from your hand onto the field. The job mannequin forwards your control gain plus 1,000 power. For each job mannequin you control, X-Death gains 1,000 power. Holy shit. Wow, that is good. Because there's another card here that I'm actually interested in. Is it? I think it's a common. It's a Final Flash, the Dragon Ball Z thing. So, Fleeting Flash, if you control Mannequin, other than Fleeting Flash, Fleeting Glass Stain gains 2,000 power. That's actually pretty good, because there's another Mannequin as well. I forgot what it was. I'll try and find it. It wasn't Imaginary Champion. I don't think it's Ice, because the 2 Ice ones are a bit awkward. But yeah, the synergy with that is really cool. There's some really good synergy there, but that's a really interesting one, X-Death. I might have to look into using that card. Because I really want to make it like a mannequin deck as well. I think it'd be quite fun. A mannequin deck with Earth, Lightning, and Ice already. That's cool, yeah. I quite like this. Mannequins are all Cs, are they? Okay. Oh, I forgot the common pile from today. There's a mannequin there. That's water, though. Yeah, I'll have to look through that and, you know, discuss it with a couple of people on Reddit and Gaff and all that stuff, like what people are doing. I quite like that one there. That can be quite interesting. I'm definitely going to make, like, a mannequin deck. I think it'd be quite interesting. This one here, this one's a really good one as well. Yeah, mannequins are a great budget deck. When Imitation Liegeman enters the field, choose 1 forge your opponent controls, deal it 2,000 damage. If you control Mannequin other than Liegeman, it gains 5,000 damage instead. So yeah, like the whole synergy with Mannequins, and I know that Moogle is a new one as well, it's pretty interesting. Definitely, I think you're right there, it's a good budget deck, because they're all just commons. So you're going to get plenty of them anyway. But yeah, X-Death, that's cool. When I make a Mannequin deck, that's definitely going to go in. That's good, that was a really good, really cool card there. I just realised, well, if you could... It's wind... You said with Earth, Lightning and Ice. Oh, no, it's not... Riku EX is wind, isn't it? Because it goes with the Gullywings shit. Yeah, Gullywings, yeah, it's wind. The standard unit deck. There's that one card which says if you control standard unit, you gain like 1,000 for each as well, isn't there? I forgot what it was, but it was a pretty decent card.
But the legends I want are the only ones I don't have a copy of.
Oh, okay.
What legends are you looking for, then? So I've got Yang. Also, where did you come from as well, Brekka? Because I put this on, like, two different forums. Like, are you from Reddit as well? Speaking of Reddit, we've got Redis. Cecil and Yuna. I've actually got those as well, I think. It was just over here. Yeah, I've got those. I've got the Cecil. So you're looking at the water Cecil, that one. And the Yuna, which is this one here, yeah. Those ones. Oh, yeah, because they're both water, so obviously you can put them together and it'll work. Bard. Ranger. Ouroboros Simaculum. Whatever the Ouroboros, we'll just call it. Summoner. Herdy. Leviathan EX. Fran. I don't have Balthier yet. That'd be quite cool. Fran is the rare. Mateusa Corrupts. Sifa. Porom. That's the rare. Oh, that was it. That was the pack. Yeah, I'm pretty sure I'm going to get a Balthier because I just stated I'm going to get... I just mentioned that card. I'm pretty sure I'll be getting a Balthier then. Speaking of mannequins, here's Imitation Liegeman. Imitation Liegeman. Astrologian. Ninja. I want Cecil to put in a budget deck aside from him just to boost everything. Yeah, I haven't actually... Isn't it like... let me have a quick check. It's basically... If possible, Cecil must block. I thought that was kind of a weird one, yeah. Cecil doesn't receive any damage from summons or abilities. All forwards other than Cecil you control gain 1,000 power and don't receive any damage from summons. Oh, wow, I just realised. Oh. All forwards other than Cecil you control gains 1,000 power and don't receive any damage from summons or abilities. All forwards. Aren't mannequin forwards? You've got backup mannequins like Felicious Wander and that, but... Are they all forwards? Yeah. Oh yeah. Where's the other ones? That's a forward, that's a forward, that's a forward. Oh yeah, no, they're all forwards, yeah. That's pretty interesting actually, yeah. That's not too bad. I know that Balthier goes really well with the Fran card as well. It's something along those lines, like, oh, if you've got, like, pull Fran into your hands or something like that. So we'll continue on with this pack. So, Ninja, Machinist. Yeah, oh, is it really standard? Oh, yeah, because it's all forwards, isn't it? Yeah, that's actually pretty cool. It's quite interesting, that. Semblance of a Witch Mannequin. Ward, Sage, or Sagi. We'll call him Sagi. Moomba EX. Oh, that's cool. I like that one. Belius Agigas. Pain EX. That's cool. I can go with my Riku EX. Porom is the rare. And Al Cid. That's actually my second. I've actually got a holo foil thing of that. Probably Pokemon again. Holo. I don't know it's actually what the term of it is. I'm just going to call it holo foil. So I think I'm on the last 10 packs now. I've just bent the back card as well. I hope it's not something good. Oh, for fuck's sake. I think I don't know what I just bent. You see what I was just saying? I was just telling psychologists in chat, I mentioned a card, it appears. Guess what? Got a Balthier. It happens. It just happens. And I think I might have just bent the back of it. Yeah, look. Wow. Oh, that is bad. That I just realized as well, like, why do some of my backs have some of the bends? Holofoil, it's all good, yeah. I told you, I just mentioned a card. Next thing you know, out comes a Balthier. It just happens. Good. I was just talking about Balthier. I mention it, and then, yeah, just get it. Oh, this is really weird. So, yeah, I was just... Yeah. Whenever one of your backups enters the field, activate Balthier, choose a backup, someone... I did say I'm going to get a Balthier. I was talking about Fran, the last pack, and I was like, all I need is Balthier, and in the back, well, there's my Balthier. Yep, so there we go. I can tell you, these things are just really weird. My pack openings for stuff is really weird. So Time Mage, David Hasselhoff, Zell, Imaginary Champion, Ranga, Monarch, Ninja, Vincent is the rare, Nero is also a rare, and that's also a rare, Drace. That's cool. But yeah, got Balthier. Ha! Knew that was going to happen at some point. Is that all seven non-foils as well then? Yeah, I think you're right. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Yeah, so that's all my non-foils thingamajigs. So this pack here, just so you know, because apparently there's a trick where if you pick the bottom left pack, no, the bottom right sets, you get all the good stuff. And so far, I've rinsed through like a lot of that stuff already. The first pack was on the right, second pack was in the middle, and then the third set was on the left. So I'm going to assume this has got crap inside of it. I might be wrong, though. I might have a couple of foils. This is why I keep bending the back one, because I keep doing this, pulling it towards it. I should just do that and then pull away from it. Because I was looking at some of my cards and I was like, what the hell? Why are they all bent? But yeah, this whole calling out a card thing is really, really scary. Anyway, Leviathan EX, Sifa. Yang from Street Fighter, Final Flash, Rosa, Mont Blanc, Lemon Sorbet, Phantasmal Harlequin. Oh, that's new. Oh, no, it's not. Oh, yeah, it's that thing with a creepy ass face. Look at that. Like, that thing has seen some shit. Rosso, Giss, and Hero Dr. Sid. So pull away this time and let's not ruin the cards, shall we? I know that in Japan as well, like when you watch them unbox like Pokemon cards, even Final Fantasy cards, they get scissors and cut them, but I'm always like, I'm just going to cut the cards off, I know I am. But there was an event I went to and people were doing that. I was like, man, just open up the packs. I'd rather have a little bit of a bent side than cutting the top of a card off. Next thing you know, you've got a Pikachu without a head. So Ifrit, Leviathan, Ninja, Phantasmal Harlequin, Monk, Gertie, Ninja, Shola, Hollow. That's cool. I like that. That thing that's seen some shit. Jill Nabat. Oh, that's cool. Agrius. Oh, it's just a normal. I thought it was a Hollow. Oh, and we've got Lydia the Nuke. Oh, I like this card. This is a pretty cool card. I think you said you was running Lightning or Earthen, didn't you? So you've got this card here, which is essentially just a nuke. You may use Ridia's special ability by discarding an Earth summon instead of a card name. So you know, like how obviously you've got the S there, so it says get rid of either the same card. Well, this card actually lets you play this if you've got an Earth summon as well, which is really cool. So you can essentially just be like, oh, I know it's off. Where's the Earth summon? So yeah, it can be like, okay, cool, let's get rid of Lydia, which is exactly the same thing. What's the point? So get rid of that Earth Summon, and then the next thing you know, you've got this nuke about to happen. It's a really scary card, because basically, this deals 7,000... So, for the same aura summon, plus 3 Earth Energy, deals 7,000 damage to forwards of any elements except Earth. So you can have like a full mannequin set, and you can be like, cool, and it's just counting down. Next turn, there's going to be a nuke going off. It's pretty crazy, because you can play that, it comes in dull obviously, and you know that next turn you've got to get rid of that card, because it can wipe out your entire board if you don't have any Earth summons on there, Earth forwards and stuff. It's pretty cool. Really scary card to go against if you've got like a full set of forwards and no Earths. But it also deals damage to yours as well, I think. Yeah, it deals damage to your forwards as well, so if you don't have any Earth forwards... Or you might end up wiping out some of your own as well. But it's a really cool like nuke just to wipe out the entire board. Let's pull away. Right, nothing like David Hasselhoff to start off this card, this sum set. So, we've got David Hasselhoff, Time Mage, Zell, Elemental Vision, Mont Blanc, Semblance of a Lion, Felicious Wanderer, Elemental, Ephemeral Vision, Palom, an Out of Focus Vanille, Kane, and the Hero's Arc from Final Fantasy III. What was this one? Oh yeah, here we go, this is what I was talking about. The job standard unit forwards you control gain 1,000 power. So, that's quite interesting. There might be one, if you haven't used that yet, you might want to consider that one maybe. It's only a 2-drop, so you can get yourself buffed quite quickly with that, with Arc. So we've got Horn, Black Mage, Batman, Chocobo, Black Mage, War of Antiquity, whoops. The Lemon Sorbet. Oh, my second holo Alcid. Shawla. That's the rare. Oh, yeah, sweet. Yeah, War of Light job buffs standard really well. Oh, that's cool. Yeah, I didn't actually notice that, the War of Light as well. Riku EX, which I like. I know I need one more. Saz as the rare. And Palom as the hero. Oh. Not bad, not bad. Ark and Riffia. Building that Final Fantasy III deck. Ooh, I can see a Wind Holo file in this. It might be what I think it is. So we've got Yes Yes, Scholar, Warrior. Oh, that's cool. Ouroboros Simulation, Semblance of a Witch, Capricious Reaper, Sarge. Oh, it's Penelo, yeah. So Penelo is the holo thingamajig. Lydia, Renoa, Quistis, and Edward. Oh, that's cool. It's the first full art Edward I've got here. So choose a doll and choose a forward and just dial it for 2 and a tap. Not bad. Also, I just put the hero into the legendary pile. So the last two packs, and then I'm going to recap on everything I picked up when I've finished bending the top left-hand side of the cards. Ugh. So here we have Astrologian, Kyrios, Ninja, or Ryu Hayabusa I should say, Ward, Herdy, Dragoon, Warrior. What the hell? There's a little floating face there. Oh, that was you sending a little emote thing. Because I'm using, like, I'm live streaming through my iPhone. So I was like, what the hell? There's a little floating face just came out of nowhere, like praying or something. Yeah, we're a Balthier normal eyes, the Fran one. Not the legendary one, but I've got Balthier. Teller. Okay, Grammys I've already got. And Cagnazzo, that's my second one now, actually. I'm quite surprised. Those seem to be quite common to get. But that's my second Cagnazzo. The really awkward card. Here we go, final pack. The final packy. We'll put it in and we'll get it. So Ifrit, Knight, Sifa, Edward, Capricious Thief, Carbuncle, Viking. There we go, Holo Fran, that's quite cool. Finish off with a nice row. Hashmall, Bringer of Order. These are one drop. We've got Hash Browns. That is a hero, isn't it? Is it a hero? No, yeah, I was going to say it's not a hero because it's not a thing. Anyway, Zargabath, Rosa, and we finished off with a hero, which is LeBlanc, which is pretty meh. Is it the thing? Put one name on me. Yeah, that's cool. So yeah, that was actually not too bad. That was a really good box. A lot of really cool stuff there. The legends were definitely the highlight because there was some damn good stuff I got from that box there. Stuff that I'm actually interested in using. Overall, I'd say that was good. I did quite like the stuff I managed to pull out there. Here's what I got overall. So that's all of the commons. Here's all of the rares. This box is going to fall over as well. Here's all the rares, all the heroes, all the legends, and then I've just put these into a file of EX bursts as well, and I think I've kind of messed up a little bit there because I'm sure there's a few EX bursts just floating around and stuff. So I'm going to sort these out anyway. I'm going to recap some of the cool stuff. You're going to buy another box tomorrow. That's cool. You should I'll follow you or on Twitch or anything like that. Or just, I guess if you're on Reddit, post it on there. But yeah, that was good. just recap on the highlight, which is obviously the legendaries. So we've got Urien from Street Fighter, Vayne, Rinoa, Hollow Tifa, Balthier, Vincent, Tifa, the Emperor, Edia, Yuna, and a normal Nora as well. If I don't get a Cecil, I'm coming to get you. Fair enough.
What do you mean this one here? This
Cecil, this one specific Cecil you're talking about, this card here that I have in my hands. So I tear up. This one specific Cecil that you need. Nah, I'm sure you. I'd be surprised if you didn't get it anyway. I mean, you're guaranteed 7 non holos, non foil legendaries. But yeah, that was cool. So yeah, that was the legendaries. I'm going to sweat out all the commons in that as well. Sweat out all the commons. Here's all the heroes I picked up as well. So I got a 4 and non foil Cecil Capo. got LeBlanc, Cagnasso, Lydia the Nuke, Al Cid, Palom, Edward, Shawla, Ark, Dr. Cids, Al Cid, Palom, Xdef, Skull, Ashura, Barbarossa, Ignis, Irvin, Zemus, Barbarossa, Luneth, Ralbon, Eishi, Golbez, fuck if I know how to pronounce that, Refia, Irvin, Kane, Parom, Edge, Bash, Edia, Edge, Shulk, Rubicante, and Fusoya. Got a full teeth in your very first Opus 2 pack. Damn, that's cool, man. That's nice. I'm going to make that a highlight, that one pack where I just got two Tifas in that one pack. That was ridiculous. Man, Jesus. That was insane. That was absolutely insane, that was. I guess I'll start sorting these out as well, actually. All the legendaries can go into here. Start sorting out the foils. Oh, I've actually got more. Oh, I've actually got 3 Skulls. I just realised my last one came with a Skull as well. So I've actually got a play set of Skulls. It's not too bad. Where did I put the rest of them as well? Oh, I see. They're all in that pile over there. Ralbon. Oh yeah, I do have it. What the fuck? It's like there's a random Dartrix inside there. Yeah, there's the next Ralban. The Holo 4 Ralban. There's the other Al Cids. These are all from the packs that I did the other day where I opened 17 packs and got like all of this stuff. It was really, really good stuff. So I'm gonna put these all into a pile and get sorting them out. Still like the old school better. Yeah, I managed to get one of the old Skulls, the first wave Skull as well. Because there's actually 2 different versions of Opus 1 Skull, the first wave and the second wave. But I don't have a second wave, I've only got a first wave. Just trying to find it here. All it is just Skull is standing on the left rather than the right. Because wave 1 he's standing on the left, wave 2 he's standing on the right. Where is this Skull card? Oh, it's there somewhere. Oh, the Legend Skull. Oh, okay. That's cool, that's nice. Yeah, I missed out on a lot of Wave 1 stuff, annoyingly. Should have just bought loads of cards back then. That's pretty cool, that's a really good card. I don't really see many people using it, though, that's the thing. I'm not too sure, like, how much use it has. I can't even remember what it does. It's not like Pokemon, we know the cards off by heart, but this one, that Skull one, yeah, I can't actually remember what it does. Well, one of the first packs I ever bought as well contained the Legendary Laguna. I didn't really realise at the time what I had, but everyone was like, oh, that was a really good pull, good stuff. I was like, I don't get it. Even now, I still don't really get it. I'm still really new to the whole game. But I may as well just grab an Opus 2 box. At least I'm kind of set because I've got plenty to work with here. I do have about, I think I got in total about 10 packs of Opus 1 over the course of it coming out. Free cost 6,000 power. Oh. Oh. Let me quickly just YouTube that, Google that. Oh, yeah, I've seen this card, yeah. I just can't remember what the attacks were. Deal 6,000, 3,000 damage. Okay, yeah. Nice. Yeah, yeah. There's a bit of a mess going on here as well with these ones. Yeah, this is all Season 2, well not Season 2, Opus 2 stuff. Random. This all needs to be sorted because it's... Oh, this is... See, this here's all wrong because it's Opus 2 mixed with Opus 1. This is Opus 2. No, this is Opus 1. More of light. Whoops. Oh, because I sorted them out into the things. Yeah, Legendary Laguna. I managed to get that one as one of my first packs. Oh, there we go. Legendary Squall. I have it. I didn't even realise. Oh, and there's the normal Squall. Whoops. Moved the camera over there. Oh, I didn't even realise I had a Legendary Squall the whole time. Like, I read... I didn't even... What the hell? I didn't even know I had Legendary Skull the whole time. That was pretty cool. Oh, Mill deals 6,000 damage. When Skull is blocked or is blocked, choose one for you may deal it 6,000 damage. Skull gains first strike to the end of the turn. Yeah, I didn't even realise I got those Skulls. That was pretty cool. I rarely looked through my Opus 1 stuff. Bartz has all the jobs. Sid Highwind. I really want to give this card a go. I think it's quite funny. Your opponent puts two of the top cards of his or her into the break zone. I really want to make a deck out of this just to really annoy people. I really think it would be quite a fun card to play. All right, Alexander, choose one called... Oh, yeah, that's what you were saying earlier on. It's basically an alternate Alexander. Archer, Hecaton Chair. Shiva. Don't know. Got some Sephiroth promos here. Got some another one over there somewhere. Angrius. Yeah, that's pretty cool. I didn't even realise I had the Legendary Skulls in that and stuff. Yeah, these cards all need sorting out now as well. In the mill deck. Yeah, that's what I want to make, a really funny mill deck and stuff. It's funny, I've got one in Pokemon, which is involving like Wailord EX. Basically, the whole idea of this one deck... I mean, in Pokemon, you're supposed to... Well, so I can show you an example here. You like play your obviously your attacks with energy. This deck runs no energy. You're just sitting there forcing them to discard stuff and just waiting out. You know, laying it out like it's X-Tekken or something. So, yeah, I think it'd be quite funny to make a card deck like that in this game. Especially someone for me who's a complete noob. I might come up with something people haven't seen. Got two legendaries there as well. That was one of the first legendaries I got from the two. Legendary Sephiroth there that I managed to pull. Actually, no, I'm going to keep that separate because it's Opus 1. There's a Zand. My second Zand. Yeah, I would make a really funny kind of deck because there's the other one as well, which is Imaginary Champion from Opus 2, which is essentially as soon as you play this card, you and your opponent have to discard a card from their hands. And I'm thinking, like, I could make a really funny deck where I just create a wall and I start playing Sids and stuff and then just, you know, forcing them to, like, just lose all their cards. I just want to give it a try, you know, see if it works. It would just be really funny. And have, like, loads of block stuff. It's just, like, with Nero at the front, like, Nero to freeze them all the time. I don't know, it's going to be really funny. I really want to give that a go. I think it's a deck I'm actually going to be building, especially when you combine it with this card here, which is this and Riku EX, wherever it is, which I've managed to get two now, I think. I'm really happy about that. I've got two Riku EXs. Where is she? Maybe it was two Pain EX. Yeah, I've only got two Pain EXs, but I've got one Riku EX. But yeah, it's like, oh, by the way, when it enters your field, activate all the forwards you control. Cool, sounds good to me. Then you've got Aerith with Planet Protector as well. So it's like, cool, I'm going to put everything back up again. I think it'd just be really fun to make like a deck where you're just constantly building a wall, but you're not dealing damage, you're just forcing them to mill, so you win by no point damage, but just causing them to constantly run out of cards. I just think it would be really, really funny to play something like that. So I'm gonna build a deck around that. Especially because I think I've got a lot of really good Season 2 stuff here, or Opus 2 even, I should say. So I'm going to give that a go. And then if there's any cards from Season 1 that I still need to grab, the Opus 1 Riku backup, because that means you can call for Pain and everything else as well. I think I've got a Riku backup here somewhere, one of the first ones. Do you know what the number of that Riku is from Opus 1 is? It's an even better mill card. This is all Opus 2 stuff. Where's my Opus 1 Riku? Because I've got one here somewhere. Funny enough, on eBay as well, I managed to pick up a Shantotto for like £3. It was really cheap. I don't know. That's what I was saying earlier on, but eBay is a really good place to get some of these cards, because they're really cheap. And they do a lot of good deals on it as well. Whoops. Which Riku is this? Again, I'm not too familiar with Opus 1. Three different Rikus in Opus 1. Tama, I think, would be quite cool as well, because that means I can take a card back into it and then just play it again to, like, cause them to mill. And I reckon you can use Squall at the front as a backup, so if it attacks, you just dull all their backups and it gains, like, loads of attack damage. Where's that Riku? I really don't have much of Opus 1. There's three different Rikus in Opus 1. I know there's that really good Riku. Oh, wait. I've got the starter pack here, actually, for 10. Valfor, Pain... It's not this one, is it? Oh, yeah, this is... Oh, so 1089H. Oh, it's a hero. I'm pretty sure I've got one here somewhere. I've just seen it, like, not too long ago when I was flicking through. Yeah, there's another one to discard a card from each other's hands. Be quite funny. I'm gonna give that a go. Riku, it's 1089H. I'm sure I've got one. I've got so much Opus 2, it's ridiculous. I've got barely only Opus 1 stuff. But if I don't have that Riku, I can just buy it off eBay. No one's really going for it anyway, so I'm sure it'd be like £1 or so just to grab. That definitely is David Hasselhoff, though. Chocobo, this is all Season 2 stuff. That's Season 1 stuff. Oh. Where was that Riku? I just saw it here. Whoop, crap. I'm sure I've got one. I've seen another Riku that I've got. Yeah, I'll definitely put that in the right order. Where is this Riku? Yeah, I've got it here somewhere, but you said 1089H. I'm going to quickly go check that on my computer. Ooh. See what that card was, what it looks like even. 1-089H. Oh, that Riku card. Yeah, no, I don't have that one. Yeah, that's definitely, I've got the other two Rikus, but not that one. So I'll have to, let me quickly go check actually what it was again. What did it let you do? 1-089H. Oh wow, yeah. That's a really good card. I'm definitely gonna pick up three of those. I don't have any of those and it's quite cheap on eBay at the moment. So I'm gonna quickly just buy some afterwards. But yeah, I'm going to make a really cool deck out of something like that and give it a go. See how it works. Is there any cards you guys wanted to see? Because I'm probably going to end the stream in a bit. Might do something afterwards and sort the cards out. But yeah, if there's any cards you guys want to see or anything like that, then let me know. I'll pick them up, throw them off even. Cool. Well, I'm gonna leave it there then. I'm gonna sort these cards out. Grab some food as well because I'm starving. Don't know what to make. And I'll take a picture and post it on Reddit like what I've picked up so far. But yeah, thanks for stopping by. And I might do some more when I pick some more cards up later on. But yeah.